Hello friends, in this video we'll be seeing the previous gate questions which are asked in the topic of limits, fits and tolerances. So coming to the metrology and instrumentation subject, so frequently the questions from the topic limits, fits and tolerances are asked in gate engineering service exam and from the government job exams. Okay. So coming to the first question, this is the question which is asked in GATE 2015 for 1 mark. So coming to the question, holes of diameter 25 is the basic size which is given. Upper deviation is 0.040 mm, lower deviation is 0.020 mm, right? Are assembled interchangeably with the pins. Pins means you can assume this as a shaft. With pins of diameter, basic size is 25, upper deviation is given as 0.005 mm, lower deviation is given as 0.008 mm. We need to find the minimum clearance in the assembly, right? So coming to the question, so let's find out the limits of the hole. So upper limit is equal to basic size plus upper deviation. So which comes as basic size is 25 mm for a hole, plus 0.040 mm. So it comes around 25.04 mm. Now next, finding the lower limit of the hole. So lower limit of the hole is given as basic size plus lower deviation. So in this question, you can see that upper deviation and lower deviation both are above the basic size. Okay. So lower limit of the hole, it comes as 25 plus 0.02 mm. So it comes around lower limit of the hole as 0.25.02 mm. Okay. Next, let's find out the upper limit and lower limit of the pins, which you can also call it as a shaft. Okay. Fine. So let's find the limits of the shaft. Upper limit of the shaft, you can write it as basic size plus upper deviation. So basic size is 25 plus 0.005 mm. So it comes around 25.005 mm. So if you look at the dimensions of the pin or shaft, the upper deviation is above the basic size and the lower deviation is below the basic size. So we can write the lower limit of the shaft as basic size minus lower deviation minus because as the lower deviation is below the basic size, right? As the lower deviation is below the basic size, we have written the minus here. So let's find the lower limit of the shaft. It comes around 25 minus 0.008 mm. So it comes around 24.992 mm. So we need to find the minimum clearance in the assembly. So for better understanding, let us sketch these parts, hole and shaft. So here I am drawing the hole with the upper limit and lower limit. So this is the hole which I am specifying. So this I am considering it as a hole, right? So its lower limit, and let us assume this is the upper limit of the hole, right? Now let us draw the shaft. So as it is the clearance fit will occur when the shaft size is less than the hole size. Means if the shaft is able to translate or if the shaft is able to rotate in the hole, the assembly formed is called as a clearance fit, right? So if I draw the figure of a shaft, so let me draw it. Its size will be less than the hole size. So this is the shaft and its corresponding limits. Let us assume this is the lower limit and this is the upper limit. I am calling this as a shaft. Okay, so generally the minimum clearance between the hole and shaft, the minimum clearance between the hole and shaft occurs between the lower limit of the hole and upper limit of the shaft. The minimum clearance occurs between these two limits. So minimum clearance, I am writing it as lower limit of the hole minus upper limit of the shaft. So it comes around, the lower limit of the hole is 25.02 minus upper limit of the shaft, it is 25.005. So if you calculate this one, we'll get the answer as 0.015. So it's a simple question. And suppose if it is asked as maximum clearance, right? So let me draw the figure. So if I indicate this as a hole with its lower limit and upper limit, right? So let us assume this is the hole which I am considering, and this is the upper limit. And if I draw the shaft like this, so generally the maximum clearance, if I draw the limits, let us assume this is the shaft, this is the lower limit and upper limit. This difference is the minimum clearance, and the difference between the upper limit of the hole and the lower limit of the shaft, which gives the maximum clearance. If I draw the figure clearly for your understanding purpose, let me draw the figure which indicates the maximum clearance between the hole and shaft. So if I consider this part as hole by indicating its limits, lower limit and upper limit, let us assume this is the hole which I am considering. So this part is the material. This part is the material, right? So this is the hole. This is the lower limit. This is the upper limit. So if I consider a shaft, let me draw the shaft like this, with its corresponding lower limit and upper limit, lower limit and upper limit. So this difference will give the minimum clearance, and this difference will give the maximum clearance. This difference will give the maximum clearance, right? So maximum clearance in the assembly is upper limit of the hole, this point, minus lower limit of the shaft, which is this point, right? So let's get into the next question, which is asked in the previous year GATE. So this is the question which is asked in GATE 2014 for 2 marks. So it is a match the following type of question. So let's see the group A. We are having the capital H fundamental deviation, which is given. We know that we are having 25 fundamental deviations for holes, and we are having 25 fundamental deviations for shafts, right? The fundamental deviations for holes is represented by capital letters, right? So the fundamental deviations for shafts is represented by small letters. So this capital letter H indicates this is the fundamental deviation of the hole. And coming to the Q, it is IT8 implies the tolerance grade, and the value of ITI is 25i. So generally we need to remember some values in the GATE exam. So generally the IT5, the tolerance grade IT5 is given as 7i, IT6 is given as 10i, IT7 is given as 16i, IT8 is given as 25i, IT9 it is given as 40i, IT10 it is given as 64i. Sometimes in the question this data will not be given, so you need to remember at least from IT5 to IT10. Okay, so IT8 indicates the tolerance grade, IT7 indicates the tolerance grade, small g indicates the fundamental deviation of the shaft, which are indicated by small letters. So the assembly given is 25H7G8. Okay, so let me draw this figure. So coming to the basic size, I'm writing it as basic size BS is equal to 25 mm. So the fundamental deviation for the hole, the fundamental deviation for the hole in this assembly is given as H. So let me draw it. This is H, and the tolerance grade, it is IT7. The difference between the upper limit of the hole and the difference between the lower limit of the hole. So capital H hole, according to the hole basis system of Fitts, the capital H hole lies on the basic size. And coming to the G8 shaft, the G lies below the basic size. So this is the G. So this is the upper limit of the shaft, and this is the lower limit of the shaft. As per the question, the tolerance grade for the shaft is given as 8. So that the difference between the upper limit of the shaft and the lower limit of the shaft, it is given as IT8. Right? So let's match the group A and group B. H indicates the hole type, fundamental deviation of the hole. IT8 in this assembly, IT8 indicates the tolerance grade for the shaft. So Q goes for 4. IT7, it indicates in this assembly, IT7 indicates the tolerance grade for capital H hole. So R goes for 3. And small g indicates the fundamental deviation of the shaft. So S implies 1. So P matches to 2. Q matches to 4. R matches to 3. S matches to 1. So as per the options given, option D is the correct answer. So let's get into the next question, which are asked in the previous year's GATE. So coming to the GATE 2012 question, which is asked for 1 mark. So in an interchangeable assembly, right, shafts of size 25, which is the basic size, upper deviation 0.04, lower deviation 0.01 mm, mate or assemble with holes of size, given size, we need to find the maximum interference in microns, right? So we need to find the maximum interference which is occurring in this assembly. So let's find out the sizes or limits of the holes and shaft. So coming to the shaft, the upper limit of the shaft is it is equal to basic size plus upper deviation. So it is equal to 25 plus 0.04. So it comes around 25.04 mm. Lower limit of the shaft, you can see that the lower deviation is negative. It means the lower limit of the size will be less than the basic size. So we will be writing the lower limit of the shaft as basic size minus lower deviation. So it comes around 25 minus 0.01. So it comes around 24.99 mm. Fine. So similarly, find out the limits for the hole. So lower upper limit of the hole, you can write it as the limits, as the deviations of the holes are positive, means upper limit of the hole and lower limit of the hole will be greater than the basic size. So upper limit of the hole is equal to basic size plus upper deviation. So let's calculate it. 25 plus 0.03, so it comes around 25.03 mm. Find out the lower limit of the hole. It is equal to basic size plus lower deviation. So it comes around 25 plus 0.02 mm. So it comes around 25.02 mm. So we need to find the maximum interference in the assembly. So interference fit occurs. The main important concept is interference fit means it implies the shaft size must be greater than the hole size. So let's draw the given dimensions. So let us take the first component as hole. Let us indicate that part in terms of a figure for better understanding purpose. So let us draw the limits. This I am considering it as a hole. This is the solid material which I am considering, the hatched portion. So this hatched portion which I am drawing or indicating is the solid material. Fine. So let's indicate the dimensions. So this is the lower limit. Its value is how much? Lower limit of the hole, 25.03 mm. So this is 25.03. Let us indicate the upper limit of the hole. So its value is, lower limit of the hole is 25.02 mm. Upper limit of the hole is 25.03 mm. Coming to the shaft, upper limit is 25.04, which is more than this limit, and lower limit is 24.99. Okay, so let us draw the shaft. One of the limit is more than the upper limit of the hole. So please observe carefully. I'm just drawing the dimensions or limits of the shaft. One limit of the shaft, this I'm considering it as a shaft. Upper limit of the shaft, it is 25.04 mm. It is 25.04 mm. The lower limit of the shaft is 24.99 mm, which is less than the lower limit of the hole. So let me draw the lower limit of the shaft below the lower limit of the hole, this is the lower limit of the hole. This is the lower limit of the shaft, which is equal to 24.99 mm. So in this question, we need to find the maximum interference. Interference occurs when the shaft size is greater than the hole size. So if I consider lower limit of the shaft with lower limit of the hole. So I can see the lower limit of the shaft, it is 24.99 mm, which is less than 25.02 mm. Okay. I can see that, I can observe that lower limit of the shaft is less than lower limit of the hole. Fine. Similarly, if I consider lower limit of the shaft, with upper limit of the hole, I can see that lower limit of the shaft is 24.99 mm, which is less than upper limit of the hole, which is 24.03 mm. Okay. So lower limit of the shaft is less than lower limit of the hole, and lower limit of the shaft is less than upper limit of the hole. It means lower limit of the shaft when assembled either with lower limit of the hole or upper limit of the hole, it forms It forms clearance fit. But we need to find interference fit, right? We need to find the maximum interference. So please see that how can we get the interference fit in the assembly. So interference fit means we need to have shaft size greater than the hole size. So if we consider upper limit of the shaft and lower limit of the hole, we can get maximum interference. So maximum interference in the assembly we will get with upper limit of the shaft minus lower limit of the hole. So it comes around, upper limit of the shaft is 25.04 minus lower limit of the hole is 25.02 mm. So it comes around 0.02 mm. It comes around 0.02 mm, which is also equal to 20 microns. So if I write this as 0.02 mm, so 0.02 into 10 power 3 to convert into microns. So it comes around 20 microns. So coming to the options, option C is the correct answer. So let's get into the next question from the topic limits, fits and tolerances, which are asked in the previous year GATE. So this is the question which is asked in GATE 2011 for 1 mark. So let's get into the question. A hole is dimension 9, which is a basic size. Upper deviation is 0.015, lower deviation is 0 mm. The corresponding shaft is of dimension 9 with its upper deviation plus 0.01 plus low with its lower deviation 0.001 mm. We need to find what is the resulting assembly has which kind of fit, whether it is a loose running fit or close running fit. This both comes under clearance fit, right? Next is the transition fit and the next is the interference fit. So let's first find the limits of the hole and shaft. So let's get into the hole. So the lower limit of the hole, which is equal to basic size plus lower deviation, it comes around 9 plus 0, it is equal to 9 mm. So upper limit of the hole, it is equal to basic size plus upper deviation 9 plus upper deviation is 0.015. So it is 0.015. So it comes around 9.015 mm. So let's see in a similar fashion, find the limits for the shaft. So the lower limit of the shaft, it comes around lower limit of the shaft is called basic size plus lower deviation. It comes around 9.001 mm. Upper limit of the shaft, it comes around 9.01 mm. So let us sketch these values. So first I am drawing the part hole. So this is the hole. Let me keep the material portion or solid material portion with this hatched line. So now I am drawing the limits of the hole. So let us indicate this is the lower limit and let us indicate this is the upper limit. So this portion which I am showing by the hatched portion is the solid material. It is a solid material part, right? So the lower limit value, it is how much? Lower limit of the hole is 9 mm. So this comes around 9 mm. The upper limit of the hole, it comes around 9.015 mm. So let me draw the shaft with its corresponding dimensions. So shaft, the lower limit is 9.001, which is slightly more than this. So let me indicate the lower limit at this point. The upper limit is 9.01, which is slightly less than this one. So let me indicate like this. Sorry. So I'm drawing the upper limit of the shaft. So this is the this is the corresponding shaft. So this is the corresponding shaft with its limits. So if I draw clearly, give me a minute. Yes, 1 minute, please. So this is the hole which I have drawn. So shaft, one of the dimension is more than 9 mm, like this. The lower limit is more than 9 mm, the lower limit of the shaft, and corresponding upper limit of the shaft. This is the corresponding upper limit of the shaft. So this is the shaft, lower limit and upper limit. So if you see the exact dimensions, so this is the lower limit of the hole, if I draw for the hole, and this is the upper limit of the hole, and corresponding shaft, this is the lower limit of the shaft, and this is the upper limit of the shaft, this is the lower limit of the shaft and upper limit of the shaft. So you can see that the dimension, the limits of the hole, the limits of the shaft lie in between limits of the hole. Okay. So whenever the limits of the shaft lie in between the limits of the hole, okay, so this comes under transition kind of fit. This comes under transition fit. So transition fit means, you can see here, if the upper limit of the hole, if the upper limit of the hole and upper limit of the shaft, if they are assembled, the shaft size is less than the hole size, it forms clearance fit. Sorry. Okay. And if the lower limit of the shaft, and the lower limit of the hole, if they are assembled, the lower limit of the shaft is more than the lower limit of the hole, right? It forms interference fit. So the fit may be either a clearance fit or an interference fit, depending upon whether you are taking which kind of limits. If you are taking upper limit of the hole and upper limit of the shaft, if you are considering the upper limit of the hole and upper limit of the shaft, the fit formed is clearance fit. And if you are considering the lower limit of the shaft and lower limit of the hole, the fit formed is interference fit. So the fit may be either a clearance fit or an interference fit, depending upon the limit values of holes and shafts. So this kind of fit is called as a transition fit. So coming to the option C is the correct choice. So let's get into the next question. So this is the question which is asked in GATE 2010. This is the question which is asked in GATE 2010 for 1 mark. So let's get into the question. So a shaft which is having a dimension, basic size is 35. Lower limit minus zero, sorry, upper deviation minus 0.009 mm, and lower deviation minus 0.025 mm, right? the respective values of fundamental deviation and tolerance. We need to find the fundamental deviation and we need to find the tolerance for the shaft with the dimension 35 minus 0.009 minus 0.025 mm. So let's get into the concept of this fundamental deviation. So please observe this definition. Fundamental deviation is either the upper deviation or the lower deviation, whichever nearer to the basic size or zero line. Okay, so please observe this. The fundamental deviation, which is called as the fundamental deviation, is either the upper deviation or lower deviation, whichever nearer to the basic size or zero line. So let us indicate this dimension of shaft. So if I draw the zero line, the basic size is given as, for the shaft it is 35 mm. You can see that both the upper deviation and lower deviation are, both upper deviation and lower deviation are negative. It means, this implies both upper limit of the shaft and lower limit of the shaft are less than the basic size. So if I indicate the shaft like this, okay, so this is the upper limit and this is the lower limit. It means from some reference point, if I draw the shaft, this is the shaft which I'm drawing. Okay, so this is the shaft. So I'm indicating this as the shaft. So from this reference, this is the lower limit of the shaft, and from this same reference, this is the upper limit of the shaft. Okay, so you can see that this corresponds to upper deviation UD, and this corresponds to, from the basic size, this corresponds to LD, lower deviation. You can see that from the upper deviation and lower deviation, upper deviation is nearer to the basic size or zero line. So as per the definition of the fundamental deviation, can be either the upper deviation or lower deviation, whichever nearer to the basic size. So upper deviation is nearer to the basic size. So therefore, the fundamental deviation is equal to the upper deviation, which is minus 0.009 mm. Right? So coming to the next part of the question, the tolerance value. The tolerance, you can write it as upper limit of the shaft or lower limit of the shaft, or you can also write tolerance, as the difference of upper deviation of the shaft minus lower deviation of the shaft. So the upper deviation is how much? Minus 0.009 minus lower deviation minus 0.025. So it comes around 0.016 mm. Okay. So as per the choice, this is the fundamental deviation and this is the tolerance. So as per the options, so we are having option D is the correct answer.